My name is Michiel van Dorst. I'm captain on the Boeing 737 at KLM. Today we are flying from Amsterdam to London Heathrow, a very short and very busy flight with a lot of interaction with air traffic control. To help us manage the heavy workload on this sector, we use the autopilot. The autopilot will enable us to fly more safely and more efficiently. There are many misconceptions about how pilots use the autopilot, and today we are going to clear those up for you. Up here we dial simple figures like speed, heading and altitudes. But as you can see, there's many more buttons on the mode control panel of the autopilot, and they are connected to the flight management computer. We will have the route in there, but also expected flight levels and speeds. So we start by putting in the origin airport and the destination airport, London Heathrow. Then we'll put in the company route, which is prepared by flight dispatch. Once I've checked it, I will activate and execute the route to make sure that this flight is pre-programmed well. In the computer, we also put the cost index. Today it is 3-0. The cost index gives the optimum efficiency between an efficient flight and speed. The higher the cost index, the higher the speed. Okay, Ernst, start engine number 2.
Number 2.
Delta 620 Alpha.
Request taxi.
Quebec and Zulu, runway 36 left.
Quebec and Zulu, runway 36 left. Get
1009. Maintain this frequency. 36 left, clear takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 36 left. Stay on the frequency. Get 1009.
Takeoff.
Positive rate.
Gear up.
Gear up. Helm up.
Autopilot Alpha.
Come on, time should be speed.
Canon 1009, call departure. 1-1-2, bye-bye.
1-2-1-2, Canon 1009, bye-bye.
VNAV.
N1, VNAV speed, reduced climb. Departure, good morning, KLM 1009 at 2000 feet, go low 3, Victor.
Hello, 1009, climb 130.
Flaps up.
Climb level 130, KLM 1009. Flaps up.
Flight level 130.
Checked. London, good morning, KLM 1009. We are maintaining flight level 240, radar heading 260.
KLM 1009, when you're ready, descend flight level 150, level by Sabre.
We're ready down to level 150 to be leveled by Sabre, KLM 1009.
I just put in a flight level 150. We have to be level flight level 150 at the point Sabre. It's already pre-programmed in the FMC. The FMC has calculated itself how far before Sabre we will have to descend to be level flight level 150 at Sabre.
London, hello, KLM 1009. We're passing level 200, descending level 150 inbound Sabre.
KLM 1009, roger that. Descend flight level 140.
Level change.
Retard, MCP speed.
Mm-hmm.
KLM 1009, descent flight level 90.
Descent flight level 90, KLM 009er.
Flight level 90.
90 checked.
Vertical speed.
Vertical speed.
Minus 1000.
1000 is checked. Cabin crew, prepare for landing.
KLM 1009,
24
miles, 09 left,
descent
QRP 6
nodes,
QNH
1009.
Flaps
1. Speed 180.
Check,
flaps 2 is set.
KLM 1009, descent altitude 5000 feet.
Altitude 5000 feet, KLM 1009.
5000 feet.
KLM 1009, left turn 180 degrees, descent 4000 feet.
Left 180, descent 4000 feet, KLM 1009.
KLM 1009, descent
3000
feet.
3000 feet, KLM 1009.
3000 feet.
Check.
Clear to intercept the localizer.
675, left turn 180 degrees.
180 degrees, speed 675.
KLM 1009, descent ILM, speed 9160 knots, until 40 and 8.
Speed 160 on turn 4, KLM 1009.
KLM 1009, call turn 9187.
Two other pilots.
187, KLM 1009 away.
Steps 5.
Steps 5. Tower low, KLM 1009, only ILS 09 and left.
KLM 1009, hello, continue approach.
Continue approach, KLM 1009.
Steps 10.
Steps 10. Cabin crew, take your seats.
Gear down.
Gear down.
Flaps 15.
Flaps 15.
Speed 160. CML. Flaps 30.
Flaps 30.
Speed pass.
Checked.
Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Change start switches.
Continuous.
Speed brake.
Armed.
Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
30 green lights.
Line check is completed.
500.
Watch out, cleared. We've got the proceeding in the runway inside.
Checked.
KLM 1009, runway 09 left. Clear to land, 70 degrees easterly, less than 5.
We're clear to land, 09 left. KLM 1009.
Landing and we're cleared.
Checked.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Speed brake up. Reverse normal.
KLM 1009 left on Alpha, hold to link 28, descend 421. Stupid 834, monitor 18.5. Monitor 18.5, stupid 834, bye. United 900, monitor 18.5.
18.5.
Parking brake set.
Checked. Power change.
So there you have it, from Amsterdam to London Heathrow, with little help of the autopilot and the flight management computer.
Positive rates.
Gear up.
Gear up.
Today to New York, we will cross the Atlantic Ocean, and there's limited or no radar coverage from ATC. That's why we follow, let's say, highways in the sky, and all the aircraft are separated from each other 10 minutes, so we have to fly a fixed speed over the ocean. And they are chosen in such a way that they are most economical. On our routing today to New York, we try to prevent the headwind. And so at this time the tracks are very southerly to prevent the 200 knots headwinds northern part of the oceanic. In a minute we're gonna request the clearance from ATC for our track today to New York. So what we do is we select here Oceanic Clearance Request. Flight number is automatically put in. Flight level. That's the flight level for the crossing. That's flight level 360.
360, yeah.
Speed that we have to fly. Set.
Yeah, check.
Okay. There's the clearance. KLM 641 is clear to Kilo Juliet Foxtrot Kilo. That's New York via SEPAL. Not Delta. SEPAL.
Checked.
And then 4615.
Checked.
4520.
Checked.
4330.
Checked.
4240.
Checked.
4250.
Checked.
4260.
Checked.
Dovi.
Checked.
Maintain flight level 360 Mach decimal 85.
Checked.
So we accept that message. And then we have again that our confirmation is received on their side. So they now know that we have received the clearance.
KLM 641 heavy to send, maintain 7,000.
KLM 641
heavy contact final
132.4. 132.4,
KLM 641
heavy. Goodbye. Flaps 1. Flaps 1. Kennedy Tower, KLM 641 heavy and 04 right.
KLM 641 heavy, Kennedy Tower, 6 miles bound and Airbus 320, wind 36017, gust 28, runway 4 right, clear the land.
Clear land, 4 right, KLM 641.
Lights low. Get down.
Get down.
Flaps 20.
Flaps 20.
Speed exhaust.
12 knots crosswind left.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Speed break up. Reverse normal.
We're going to prepare for the approach in Juliana International Airport at the beautiful island of St. Maarten. The St. Maarten runway is a bit challenging for us, that is relatively short, and the area around the airport also has some hills. So we'll do a thorough preparation for a safe approach. On the iPad we have a route app where you can see our route towards St. Maarten. Here you see the route to St. Maarten. We are at this position right now. On the other map, you can swipe towards that one, you can see our Arnav approach for runway 10. The Arnav approach is to be used by aircraft equipped with GPS, as we are today. This approach gives you a very efficient path towards the runway, and specifically at this runway we will take over manually for the last part.
Alpha Tower Grey, KLM 785. We are descending out of flight level 200, flight level 1C. Send 2600-3005, KLM 785. Cabin crew, prepare for landing.
Doing the flaps one.
Flaps one.
Flaps 5.
Flaps 5.
Gear down.
Gear down.
Flaps 20.
Flaps 20.
Landing. See the runway?
Yeah.
Autopilot off, auto throttle off.
Cabin crew, take your seats. Clear to land, KLM 785. Landing checklist, take your seats, announce speed brake.
Arms.
Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
30.
Landing checklist.
Cabin crew, doors may be opened. Welcome to Juliana Airport, Sint Maarten. I hope you enjoyed this trip as much as we did. We also hope to see you on board the 104 aircraft one day.
117 Echo, contact Langen 135.650, goodbye. KLM 565, contact Orion 133.
Hello and welcome aboard. My name is Thijs Jongsma, captain on today's flight from Amsterdam to Kilimanjaro and Dar es Salaam. Many of you have sent us questions about the flight instruments in this place. And in today's film, we're going to show you what we use them for and how they improve flight safety. The most important one is this one, the primary flight display, or PFD. It shows us our speed, altitude, rate of climb or descent, which is presently zero, and the attitude of the aircraft. Another panel we use almost constantly is the navigation display. This shows, among others, the route information, wind speeds, and aircraft in the vicinity.
This is the ECAM panel, which stands for Electronic Centralized Aircraft Monitoring. Here we can find information about the technical performance of the aircraft, such as engine power, exhaust gas temperature, and fuel flow. Any technical problems that may arise would immediately show up, mostly with the correct procedure to solve the mishap. That way we can quickly take the best course of action. Finally, the systems display, which is here, can show us a wide array of information. We can see how the fuel is distributed on this page, check on hydraulics or the electrical system, or see if the doors are secured properly, or even what the temperature is in the cabin and cargo area.
We're enjoying the last rays of sunlight in a while. We're going to prepare ourselves and the aircraft for a descent and approach into Kilimanjaro, where you'll see how essential these displays are to us. Communicating with air traffic control is essential to flight safety. Maybe you wonder how we do it. In this video, we're going to teach you the basics. Primark Amsterdam, KLM 574, passing flightable 320, descending flightable 260. If we want to talk to the air traffic controller, most of the time we use the VHF radio and talk to ATC by the push-to-talk switch, either on the communication panel or on the side stick.
Control, good morning, Speedbird 138, flight level 360.
Speedbird 138, good morning, contact. KLM 574, contact Bra 133.530, goodbye.
133.520.574.
KLM 574,
descent flight level 100.
Descent flight level 100, KLM 574. KLM 574, heavy.
KLM 574, Iman Sierra Papa Yankee, level 50 over the 185.
KLM 574, turn left, heading 270, reduce to speed 220 knots.
Heading 270, speed 220, KLM 574.
KLM 574, turn left, heading 215, to intercept ILS, clear approach, runway 18 right.
Left heading 215, clear approach, runway 18 right, KLM 574.
215 is checked, fly slope lock, get one.
Check. Step is 18 right, KLM 574.
KLM 574, roger, 4.5 miles, bent Fokker, contact tower, 118.275.
18275, KLM 574, tot ziens. KLM 574, 18 right.
KLM 574, number 3.
Number 3, KLM 574. Cabin crew, take your seats.
Gear down.
Gear down.
KLM 574, 1 is right, clear the land, the wind 1907.
1 is right, clear the land, KLM 574.
Taxi Echo
9
across
Runway 18
Center
of
Whiskey 5.
Taxi Echo 9 across Runway 18 Center of Whiskey 5,
KLM 574. KLM 574, contact
118, goedemorgen. Wacht voor een tot ziens, KLM 574. Morgenavond KLM 574, 118 Center of KLM
574, Alpha Noord Echo 9.
Alpha Noord Echo 9, KLM 574.
573, good day. Information Whiskey, QNH 1019, contact ground 1217, goodbye.
Hello, my name is Andrea van Dijk. I'm a captain on the Boeing 737. In this video, my colleague Jos Roeper and I would like to show you how a 70,000 kilogram plane takes it to the sky. It may seem complex, but it's not really that difficult. On today's flight from Amsterdam to Athens, we will show you how airplanes fly. Both the airplane's weight and the actual weather conditions need to be taken into account to determine the right speed for takeoff. For this, we send our information off to a central computer. Thereafter, we get a print back, and this information we put into our flight computer. And then we're ready for a safe takeoff.
KLM 1985, request taxi.
1985,
taxi Alpha 2.
Before takeoff checklist.
Flaps.
5, green lights.
Stabilized trim.
6.1 units.
Before takeoff, check this.
Tower KLM 1572, we're ready, holding short 24 share 7.
Order KLM 1573, clear for takeoff, runway 24.
You ready?
Check.
Takeoff.
Hey, you know?
Check. Autopilot at auto throttle off.
Check.
Flaps one.
Flaps one. Start switches.
Continuous.
Speed brakes.
Arms.
Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
30 green lights.
Landing checklist complete.
We are in the KLM Flight Crew Training Center. This is where all the simulators are. And this is where we do our training. Full motion simulators might look different from the outside, but inside they're an exact copy of the cockpit and they feel and move as a real aircraft. At least 4 times per year we do our training here, to always stay well prepared and current. I'm Jeroen Visser, I'm a captain on KLM 777. This is First Officer Erik Hoogerheide, and we will show you training in a full motion simulator and how essential these trainings are.
Ready? Take off.
V1.
Rotate. Positive rate.
Gear up.
Gear up.
Set heading select, runway heading. Set autopilot.
Autopilot. Fire engine left.
Fire engine left. Fire engine left. Memory items. Autofold alarm switch. Confirm left.
Confirmed.
Off. Thrust lever. Left. Confirm left.
Confirm. Fuel control switch left, confirmed.
Confirmed.
And your fire switch left, confirmed.
Confirmed.
Trust ref, Vina speed.
Check, inform ADC, I'd like to proceed to runway heading 3000.
Pen, KLM 755, having an engine fire, continuing runway track, 3000 feet, go you ready to maneuver.
KLM 755, your pen call has been received, 0624 and straight at 3000 feet is approved.
KLM 755, straight at 3000 approved.
As you can see, even with only one engine operating, this aircraft can fly safely. Hello, welcome aboard. I'm Captain Jeroen Visser, and together with my first officer, Erik Hoogrijden, and my second officer, Jolanda de Vlucht, we're going to be your crew on this flight to Quito. We stopped the simulator for a while to show you the surroundings of Quito Airport. As you can see outside and also here on our iPad and inside our navigation display, Quito is surrounded with high mountains, mountains which will go up to around 6,000 meters. Because of that and because of the elevation of the airport itself, the aircraft performs differently. We need more speed to get the same amount of lift for the aircraft, and the engines give less performance at high altitudes. The behavior of the aircraft is slightly different. The reason for this is that at high altitude, the air has less density, less air particles. To compensate for this, we need to fly faster to get the same amount of required lift for the aircraft at lower levels. Because of that, we have to stick very closely to our navigation profile to avoid all the terrain. And in case of a go-around, we have so-called escape routes, which will bring us to a safe area and to a safe altitude. On board of all our KLM aircraft, we have an enhanced ground proximity warning system installed. This system will provide the pilots with information about terrain, height and distance. And this will enable us to safely navigate around terrain.
Here's the city.
Autobrakes 4.
Autobrakes 4. It's beautiful, isn't it?
It is beautiful.
Runway in sight.
Check. Intercepting final. Okay, gear down.
Gear down.
Flaps 20.
Flaps 20.
Speed 160 knots.
Check. KLM 755 heavy is turning final runway 36.
KLM 755, Roger, contact Quito Tower 118.1.
118.1, bye bye, KLM 755.
Flaps 30.
Flaps 30.
Speed VRF plus 5.
Speed 144 sets.
Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Landing checklist completed.
Checklist completed.
1000.
Check.
Approaching minimums.
Check.
500.
Cleared.
Minimums.
Continue.
100.
Speed pickup. Reverse is normal.
Welcome to Quito.
Hello everybody, my name is Menno Kroon. I'm the captain on today's flight. Today is a special occasion since we're going to be joining the Royal Dutch Air Force open days with the KLM Airbus A330. We're going to be flying in a big formation, including F-16s, the Joint Strike Fighter, the KDC-10, which is the Dutch tanker, several helicopters and the beautiful Spitfire. It's a very special occasion for us since we're going to be flying in close formation with two F-16s, which is not something we do every day. It took a lot of preparation in the simulator and in the briefing room, and today is the day.
Gentlemen, welcome at the briefing.
When the air power demo, after they finished, the F-16s will come and join us. They'll be joining on our wings. So although we are 100 feet above you, you're going to be climbing through our level and we're going to be climbing after you.
We fly with a lot of aircraft. We fly with our own F-16s or other fighter aircraft from around the world. Formation flying for us is a daily business. We do it every day and normally with two or four aircraft. So we are very experienced in it. But to fly with a big aircraft like an Airbus 330, we rarely do that. It's something very different, and what you will see today will be very special for everybody.
A330-200. Dames en heren van de Koninklijke Luchtvaartmaatschappij met aan haar vleugeltips twee F-16's van de luchtmacht.
Hello, my name is Tim Tervelde and I'm a captain on KLM's Boeing 747. Remember me? In previous videos I showed you how challenging it is to land a big aircraft on a small runway on a tropical island. And also my colleague showed you, amongst others, how the autopilot works and how to land an aircraft when it's dark. And now it's your turn. Please tell us what you want to see next in KLM's Cockpitail series. You can leave a comment in the box below and stay tuned to check whether you're at
Ladies and gentlemen, hello. Welcome to our flight to Heathrow today. I'm Richard Galloway, the captain today. It is a huge honour for me to be able to fly this flight. I've actually reached the end of my flying career. I've flown this aircraft type for, would you believe it, 25 years and 25 days today. The flight is going to be to London Heathrow, which is the airfield which, just a little over 98 years ago, KLM flew their first flight. And I look forward very much to our flight to Heathrow and back again.
Clear for takeoff, Fokker 1079. Okay, takeoff clearance. Before takeoff checklist completed. Gear up. Ladies and gentlemen, hello again from the flight deck. At the moment, it looks like we're going to land in about 15 minutes from now. The weather, we're always interested in that. Well, I am. I'm British. Everybody wants to know what the weather's like in England for some reason. The wind is gentle. It's a light breeze from the west. The visibility's lovely, actually, very good. I hope you're all enjoying this very special flight with us today. It's a wonderful occasion. I certainly am. Clear to land, KLM 1079. Check. Beautiful. The very last flight of the Fokker on the day of my retirement is huge, and I'm so excited about it and delighted to do that.
It's a remarkable aircraft, really, the way it was built in those days. So yeah, this was really the final chance for a Dutchman to fly a Dutch aircraft for a Dutch airline.
Everyone who's flown the Fokker will tell you that it's a real pilot's aeroplane. You feel part of the machine. So you're directly attached to the controls, and the input that you give as a pilot goes straight to the flight controls as opposed to through a computer. And you can feel that and feel part of the aircraft. Thank you everybody for flying with us on this very last flight. There's hundreds of people in front of us. This is fantastic. Signing off. Thank you for all being here today. Hope you enjoyed it.